The opening ceremony at the 2008 Beijing Olympics was so awesome. But it was also a really important moment in the history of the Olympics. Because China figured something out here. They decided that they could use their Olympic ceremonies to try to change the world's idea of who China was. It might seem obvious in 2016, but in 2008, it was really important to China that the world see it as a major power. And so they put everything into an opening ceremony that showed that. And it showed them as technologically innovative and really numerous but coordinated, which I think is code for a powerful military, and also just a major cultural force. The ceremony was so beautiful. And it worked. But in doing that, China also changed the game of Olympic ceremonies. Opening ceremonies have always been full of fanfare and dancing and national pride, but before 2008, they never really made a statement. But China said, from now on, if you host the Olympics, you better show up with something to say about who you are. And it better look good. It's true, the opening ceremonies of the Olympics are staged and artificial, and they are propaganda, but there's also nothing else really like them. They're this combination of theater and cinema and technology, and it's all in the service of telling a story about a country. And if you know how to read that, it can tell you what that country wants. Like Russia, who hosted the Olympics in Sochi in 2014, their opening ceremony was the history of Russia. But every piece of that story was about Russia modernizing. Here's Peter the Great. He built a navy and westernized the country, and then we were awesome at ballet, and then we industrialized, then we built rockets, and we did more dancing. But there's no Stalin, no revolution, some communism. But Russia had something really clear here to say. We are modern. We are forward-looking. We are ready to be a leader in the world. The Olympics create this fantasy of what it means to be a country. Teamwork and pride, no politics, no violence. That's why you always see children in opening ceremonies. Sometimes they fly. The Olympics are a child's vision of national pride and international competition. That is why the opening ceremony I really love the most was London's from 2012. The UK wasn't an emerging world power. It's already been a world power for all of recent history. So they didn't have the same thing to prove as Russia or China did. So they did something totally different. They told the history of their country in this totally literal way. The Industrial Revolution happens, and smokestacks rise out of the ground, and there are these dirty, downtrodden workers because actual modernization is hard and complicated. And there are suffragists and immigrants. And when the Olympic rings appear, they aren't these ethereal, symbolic Christmas-like things. We actually watch them get forged by laborers. That is their opening ceremony. A lot of people thought that was weird. Kind of was, but it was also Britain's statement of what it means to be a developed, diverse world power in the 21st century, and grappling with a real, non-symbolic history in public. So, yeah, Olympic ceremonies can be fun, but the truth is that there is this tremendous drama around them. There is so much at stake. For the host country, it's not just about winning medals. It is this chance to really change the way the world sees you. And that is this huge question for Rio, which is hosting the Olympics at this incredibly chaotic time in Brazil. Their economy has fallen and there's this massive corruption probe going on, but they also have this chance to redefine themselves to the world. So that's what you should be thinking about when you watch the ceremonies around Rio's Olympics. What is it that they want us to know about them?